Well, that reminds me, you know, they talk all the time about accidents and how the growing accident rate is. I will never forget the time when they laid the finger on me. I'm going along the outer drive in Chicago, and I was at a very impressionable age. I had just gotten my driver's license, and I was all excited about that. You know, boy, wow, yeah, driver, you know, and all that stuff. And I was driving my own car. I'd been saving for 150 years, and I finally bought this car on Stony Island, and it's all shiny, and I'm out on a date with this chick, and we're driving into the city. And it would be about the equivalent of driving along the West Side Highway here. It's the outer drive. The lake is on one side, and the wind is blowing over the spanking waters. And this was also the day that one of the oddest things that I ever had happen really actually occurred to me in that car. We were coming in very early in the morning. We were going to some big deal that was going to happen in Chicago, and you had to get there early and get in line and something like that. And it was about 7 o'clock in the morning. And there was a kind of a mist blowing off the lake. And we were going along the outer drive, and we came to what they call the Jackson Park section, which is a park on the south side of Chicago. On one side is the park, and on the other side, as you come from Indiana, on your right is the lake. It's the south side of Chicago. Now, this is in the immediate vicinity of the University of Chicago, which at that time was under great fire in the press for various Bacchanalian revels that had been discovered at the University of Chicago. And by the way, I will award you the brass fig McGee with bronze oak leaf palm if you can tell me who was the professor at the University of Chicago at the time who was accused in public print and later in the courts of having been the chief leader of the Bacchanalian orgiastic revels. He later went on to win a couple of fantastic international awards and is even to this day making noise in the newspapers. Famous guy. And it was right in that period. And I'm driving along through the outer drive, and you could see the beautiful lakefront, and the wind is blowing off the lake and carrying little tiny pieces of fog past me and over the road, into the bushes, and out of the bushes came more fog, and it was swirling, and the sun was shining, and this chick was next to me, when suddenly, out of the bushes, can I have that first cut, that humoresque? That will describe it beautifully. Oh, boy. It was like an apparition. I couldn't believe it. Out of the bushes, I was waiting for the light to change. I'm in one of the little twisting by roads in Jackson Park. Out of the bushes floated three Greek nymph goddesses. Seriously, wearing long, trailing, gauze-like, diaphanous gowns, floating into the atmosphere, doing Greek dance, and behind them was a guy wearing a pair of wool pants with cloven hoof, and he was blowing golden pipes, and they went back into the bushes, and I never saw them again. I'm not inventing it. I'm telling you, I'm not. Stop it. It was one of the nuttinesses that was going on at the University of Chicago. It was a Greek dance class or something. Out for its morning calisthenics. You know, they floated through the air, these chicks. Wow, were they ever outlined against the sun. Woo! Things were picking up. And I went about another block and a half, and off to my right is this, it was an area, like an empty lot, really. It was kind of half-developed. It was grassy between the road and the lake. And I see these monsters, gigantic guys kicking footballs. Fantastic. They were wearing big black jerseys with orange sleeves, big numbers on the back, and no helmets. And they're just booting footballs and passing them around. I pulled up to look, and it's the Chicago Bears out for a morning workout. Believe it or not, something was going on down at Wrigley Field where they played ordinarily. And they were not going to practice in their field. And they're out there right on the road, throwing the football, kicking it back and forth. And here were these famous football players. I stopped and looked at that for a while. And there was one famous football player named Norman Standley. Did you ever hear of him? Norm Standley, famous kicker, famous backfield man. And he comes over to the car, and he looks at me and says, "You got a match, kid?" I says, "Yes." And I reached over, and it was, you know, I had this cigar lighter on the dash of my car. I pressed it in, and the next thing you know, my dash is on fire. You know how that thing goes. Oh, I pull it out, and he says, oh, I forget it, kid. And he goes back, and boom, he kicks a football 17 blocks. It was my one brief brush with greatness. Well, this chick is sitting next to me, and we continue on our journey. This is one of the nuttiest journeys I ever took. I go about another, maybe 3 or 4 blocks along the outer drive, when suddenly I am nailed from behind by a guy on a motorcycle. He pulls me over to the side of the road, and it is my first T.I. ticket. My very first in my entire life, I am being nailed and given a ticket. Well, now, in those days, as it is today, have you noticed how much easier it is to get a ticket in New York if you're from Jersey? Have you noticed how much easier it is to get a ticket, say, in Georgia if you're from New York? Okay. All right. That's the way it was when you were from Indiana and you were driving through the streets of Chicago. They just went out and... Oh, you've got 17 of them there. I see. You carry them around. Well, this guy laid the hand on me and he says, all right, okay, all right, Mac, where you think you're going? And, of course, everybody's passing me. My car had bad valves and everything. I could hardly, I'm going about 48 miles an hour, barely, with the wind behind me and going downhill. And these guys are whistling past. He's, all right, Mac, all right. Okay, let's see your driver's license. And I get out my brand spanking new driver's license, and he takes a look at it, and he says, 16, huh? All right. And he walks around the back. And you know that terrible moment when they're in back of you and they're looking at your license plate and they're writing something down? You want to get down on your knees or grovel or crawl or say, oh, don't, please, no. I mean, you're with a chick. You can't do that. So I'm sitting there and I'm looking with my famous ironic look. You know, Matt, who does he think he is? Boy, wait till he finds out who I am. Finds out my old man works at the dairy. That'll fix him, boy. Oh, just wait, we'll fix this one up. Well, he comes back around, he says, all right, kid. He says, here's your ticket. He says, you better show up down at the 28th Street Precinct office in the next, before 10 o'clock this morning, or else you're going to have to come in special next Monday. He says, if you want to come in this morning, it's going to be a lot easier on you. You might as well go right in this morning. Oh, wow. And here was our big date and the whole scene all laid up, and I knew that I had to be at the show or wherever the devil I was going was supposed to be there at 9 o'clock or 9:30. Now here I am going down to this place. Well, you haven't heard the rest of it, Dad. So I say, well, I'll go down there and take care of it quick. So I turn around, I go back over, cut in. I'm next in front of the 28th Street Precinct Station, and up the steps I go, and the big stone lions, and they had those big white globes and all that stuff, and over there they had Justice Will Triumph, and Will Justice holding up a thing with the scales and all. I go in, it's the first time, I figured, gee whiz, my idea of a ticket was $2. Back in Hammond, if you overparked, it was $1, that kind of thing. I figured, well, I've got $7 in my pocket. Most they can nick me for is $3.50. So I get in there. There's a long line of guys. They're all standing in line. And up in the front there is this judge. He's got a black robe, and he's given each guy about 7 milliseconds. And he had only one word, pay. He just kept saying, guilty. And then he'd go, and all the guys would sort of get white and turn to the left. Now, on the right was this little cashier's cage where there was a guy taking the dough. Nobody was going there. They were all going to the left, and they were waiting in a big crowd over there. I didn't know what it was about. I never had a ticket handed me before. So finally, it is my turn, and the judge takes my ticket. He says, Shepherd, J.P., 72 miles an hour on the outer drive, Ford V8. Yes, sir. Is this, let me see your driver's license. I hand him my driver's license. He looks at it, puts his glasses on the end of his nose, looks at it. All right. Got anything to say? Again, I wanted to fall down on my gut and scream. Please, Judge. You can't. There's a bunch of truck drivers behind me and a bunch of truck drivers ahead of me, so I say nothing. All right. This is $21 in costs. And cost? I mean, how much it cost? $21 in cost or a visit to the morgue. Next case, which will it be? A visit to the morgue. Well, I'm going to tell you what they did in Chicago. And I've never seen it anywhere else. You had your choice of paying up or going to the morgue. Well, I had $7 in my pocket, And so 30 seconds later, I'm standing over there with this other crowd, the guys with the white face. And they're all standing there quietly, shifting back and forth from one foot to the next. And the chick I'm with is sitting back there in the audience section. And I look at her and I wave. I'll be right back. You know, I'm wearing my ascot and my ham and high sweater. And I'm pretty snotty. I've got the moccasins on, the whole bit, you know, and I'm playing the thing. I'll be back, baby. Don't worry, Bob. I'll be back in a couple of minutes. Yeah. Well, they backed the paddy wagon up the side of this building, and they put about 75 of us in there standing. And all of us are hanging on the bars, and they're riding the paddy wagon. It's an interesting experience. And there was a cop in the front, there was a cop in the back, and they took us about 17 minutes through the side streets, and they unloaded us all, and we went into this long, dark, brown building that looked very official, with the stone steps, in past the desk, into a place that was very cold and had a strange smell. And they started to slide drawers out of the walls for us. One by one. They had collected in there probably, maybe 15 guys that had been hit by hit-and-run drivers, freight trains, 1941 Hupmobiles, you know, and the whole scene. And one after the other, we just walked right down there in a long line as a cop marched us past. And a man walked along with us and told us what had happened to each one. This guy here was found on Halsted Street. He was a hit-and-run driver. I hit him. We have two clues. We'll get him up for next week. This one over here, this guy was in a head-on collision with another guy. He was driving a 1938 Oldsmobile. The other guy was driving a 41 Chevrolet. The other guy we've already shipped out. Now, this one over here, and we're watching each one. We had to. One by one, we walked past. Well, it was the longest 10 minutes I ever spent in my life. I got on the outside with the sun shining down and the breeze is blowing past me. And they loaded me back into the paddy wagon. And we made the long trip through those winding cobble streets. Yes. And a half an hour later, I am picking up my blonde porcelain chick. The one with the soft blue eyes and the soft blue dress. And we are driving quietly along the outer drive at 4 miles an hour. Yes, thought you kind of would like that story. You know, now I know a lot of people are going, "Oh, that was cruel. What a cruel thing to do." It might have been cruel, but it was exceedingly educational. Exceedingly educational. And I have not heard that done anywhere else. I know this, that anybody who got that treatment learned something very, very vivid, which he never forgot. You just can't possibly. And when we got back out, and this bunch of guys, you know, we'd all been making smart, you know, just making smart comments and cracking wise in the paddy wagon. Nothing is silent, guys. Oh, hang in there. Looking at their watch, pretending like they're in a hurry. Like, how do we get back, you know? And somebody says, "Well, sure didn't pay the $21, did we, guys?" Ha ha.